What a difference a year makes. This time last year, as you know, health officials were telling everybody to stay home. The virus has had several waves since then, reaching a peak in August, then declining for a while, before rising steadily again from October to late January. Look at that.
Yeah, unbelievable. But the numbers have been dropping since then, largely thanks to widespread vaccinations, of course. And we're at an infection level we haven't seen in nearly a year. So are we close to the end of it all?
Let's bring in Dr. Scott Gottlieb. He is a former FDA commissioner who now serves on the board of Pfizer. Dr. Gottlieb, good morning. Thanks for joining us on this holiday weekend. If you consider where we were a year ago, we're actually at roughly the same place. But the benefit is this time around, we have the vaccine. Half of Americans have been vaccinated. That means roughly half of Americans have not. So with that in mind, how do we enjoy the holidays safely without allowing for another spike?
I think the situation this year is substantially different than last year. First of all, we've vaccinated a lot of the vulnerable population. So the consequences of COVID spread right now are going to be dramatically reduced from what it was last year. Many of the older Americans who are most vulnerable to COVID have been protected through vaccination. Also, keep in mind, we've had a substantial portion of the population that have been infected with coronavirus. At least a third of Americans have had this infection. So in addition to the people who've been vaccinated, there's also a lot of Americans who have immunity that's been acquired through infection. So when you look at the total picture, at least around 70% of the population has some form of immunity, either through vaccination or through prior exposure to the virus, infection from the virus, probably a little higher than that. So I think it's very unlikely that we're going to see a sharp rebound in the virus. We may see a slow smolder through the summer. We're still going to have cases. There's still going to be outbreaks, particularly in maybe summer camp settings where kids congregate. But I don't think we're going to see the kinds of consequences we saw last summer. We saw those big outbreaks in the South towards the end of the summer.
Yeah, Dr. Gottlieb, you take me to my next question, because, of course, we got this new guidance yesterday from the CDC essentially saying that kids who have been vaccinated, so those over the age of 12, can go to summer camp and don't have to wear masks outdoors. But I think there are still a lot of questions. You're a father of three kids under the age of 12. How are you handling this new guidance? And would you send your kids to summer camp?
Well, my kids will be in camp this summer, and I feel confident about the safety of that setting. The guidance itself is a little confusing. It's a little hard to implement, and I think CDC is going to need to go back and simplify it, because it still puts restrictions on what kids can do outdoors. I think the bottom line is kids shouldn't be wearing masks outside. What we need to mitigate against, what we need to guard against, is the risk that there's going to be an outbreak in a summer camp setting. We know that outbreaks don't occur in outdoor settings. We can't really prevent the risk that a single asymptomatic child who has the infection might be able to spread it to one other child. What we want to prevent is a circumstance where one child who is asymptomatic, doesn't know he or she is infected, can spread it to a lot of children. And that's just not likely to occur outside. Respiratory pathogens typically don't spread in the outdoor setting in the summer. What we have is pathogens that spread more through ingestion, so things like Coxsackie virus, enterovirus. So the risk of a big outbreak of coronavirus in the summertime from outdoor activities is very low. As you move kids inside, we need to be mindful of ventilation, the air quality in those indoor settings. Wearing masks, perhaps, where kids congregate in poorly ventilated places could be prudent this summer. But I think in terms of outdoor activities, we shouldn't be putting masks on kids. The risks of that, in terms of just the heat exposure, outweigh any perceived benefits.
Yeah, a lot of good advice for a lot of families there. Let me ask you, a renewed focus right now on the origins of this disease, whether it was an infected animal with human contact or a lab leak. Do you think we'll ever know the answer? And if we don't, what do you think are the lessons that we can do to avoid this ever happening again?
Yeah, we might never have a definitive answer to this question unless we find what we call the intermediate host, the animal where this came from, or unless we get access to information from the lab that's under suspicion in China, the Wuhan Institute of Virology, that really definitively demonstrates that this came out of that lab setting. We might never know. We know that there are circumstances that occurred in that lab that created the conditions where this could have come out of that lab. There is some circumstantial evidence that points in that direction, but I think this is going to be a battle of competing narratives. The bottom line lesson here, though, is that if we do have an index of suspicion, if we assess that there is a possibility that it came out of that lab, I think it changes how we think about lab safety around the world, and we need to put in place tighter controls and probably better surveillance around what goes on in the high-security labs, the so-called BSL-4 labs, where this kind of high-risk research is typically likely to occur.
Dr. Scott Gottlieb, we always appreciate your expertise, by the way. Dr. Gottlieb has a book coming out about coronavirus. It's called Uncontrolled Spread, Why COVID-19 Crushed Us and How We Can Defeat the Next Pandemic.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Find your favorite recipes, celebrity interviews, uplifting stories, shop our favorite deals, and so much more with the Today app. Download it now.